Mushoku Tensei is still good. Go watch it. What do you mean you want a new detailed analysis of one of the few truly great isekai out there? Okay, fine. Since my last video on the topic, go watch it, a lot of things have changed in Mushoku Tensei, but at the same time, nothing has. It is still the undisputed king of isekai, the granddaddy that will forever cast a shadow of superiority down upon the worthless masses of Sword Art Online clones. It's the one isekai that can get away with having the most unapologetically disgusting vile human being as a protagonist, and have people rooting for the scumbag at the end of it as they grow and develop as a human being, and then go back to being a piece of shit all over again. It can go from fighting gods to pee-pee nowhere good school rom-com shenanigans, marriage, and even to a travel blog, and still capture the hearts and minds of thousands upon thousands of fans. It can even have the blue-haired girl not be left in second place, as the platinum blonde takes the boy that no woman in their right mind should ever lust after. It can do all of this, and more. Yeah, I might like Mushoku Tensei. War gave it away. The second part of the second season, yes, it's one of those, I know, but my issues with Split Core aside, this newest and freshest of adaptations is all it ought to be. You even have the light novel fans complaining how spending enough episodes for a full season in an average isekai just to see Rudy get married and live a happy life for once is too rushed, and then you have the fans of the half-baked shield hero slop complaining how the show is too slow, which I can understand if your standard for a good anime is two episodes in, a dark-haired edgy teenager throwing on a long black coat spitting out cheesy one-liners along the lines of... Yes, I might be watching Eminence in Shadow for a future video, but shh, that's a secret. But I don't want to be too antagonistic. Everyone is entitled to their own opinion about anime, no matter how wrong they might be. Some people even like Danmachi, and it is our duty to accept those people. Who am I kidding? Anime fans and acceptance are not even in the same dictionary. Well, it's a good thing then that Mushoku Tensei is not divisive in the slightest. It's not like the slow, meticulous base of details piled upon details slow start, or switching from the rather action-packed end of the first season to a slow drama about erectile dysfunction would have put people off by completely changing the game or anything. Oh wait. But if our species' long and bloody history has taught us anything, it's that shonen fans are the worst kind of people, and that history will always repeat itself. Maybe it's just the latter. Anyway, remind yourself, how did the first season of this here excellent isekai go? The first part was slow world building, establishing the rules of magic and the people, what history was there to be found, and that everyone here was a deeply flawed person, but could learn to live with their own shortcomings. And then the world exploded in fire and brimstone as the end of an era came to be, in the form of season 1 part 2. And it's sort of the same here, except the first part was a little less wallowing in self-doubt, and a little more exploding bears and haha pee-pee no work, and the second part is a little less demon continent and getting punched through the gut by an angry god, and more wholesome family life and giant spiders while Roxy pees herself for some reason. At least Paul is still a terrible father, so there is some form of continuity going on. I mean, for real. What jackass tells his kid that it's okay to take on a lover while their pregnant wife's at home and worried sick? What I'm trying to say is that don't take parenting advice from a man with the name of Greyrat. Not that we as anime fans would ever get within smelling distance of the opposite sex, as they will swiftly run away, especially if they happen to be downwind of an anime convention. The point being, all of those people complaining how seeing Rudy live a happy life is boring aren't looking at the bigger picture. Mushoku Tensei is a story that moves in waves. It's just that those waves are a little less sharp than what most anime fans may have come to expect, as the standard is an episode of two of relaxation for an entire rest of the season of hype, action, and maybe sometimes even tension. Or at least that's the usual formula in genres like shonen and isekai. Now, I'm not going to sit here saying obnoxiously lofty things like how this is a show for a more grown-up audience, but the pacing at least is more along the lines of seinen than shonen. It's the contrasting nature of life. long stretches where things are quiet and even joyful for a moment of horror and tears, making the shock all the greater. Even the Demon Continent segment in Season 1 wasn't all that terrible for the most part, until Rudy got a fist-sized hole punched into him, and then all that shared experience between the characters exploded in despair and loss, followed by deep melancholy. Now, I'm not saying that that will happen again, since no spoilers, I'm just pointing out that that's the nature of what we're watching. Hi, AddedCheese here. As you may have gathered, that last segment was recorded before episode 10, but at least now even the anime-only watchers know what I was referring to. Oh, and no, this does not mean that Paul is no longer a bad dad. Oh, well, I guess it technically does, but you know what I mean. Yes, he tried to and sometimes succeeded, but still, no, not in the grand scheme of things. And I guess that's the point. Deeply flawed people and all that. Now back to past me. And now is the segment where I'd usually talk a bit about the production quality, but honestly, there isn't much to say here that hasn't already been said. It's nothing new under the sun. The same level of excellence from what we'd come to expect, but maybe with a little less ooh and ah levels of prettier pictures and dynamic camera angles. It's still the same vibrant world brought to light in great detail, and the same level of character design and personality just oozes human emotions. In this regard, Mushoku Tensei is still Mushoku Tensei, and I for one would not wish it to be anything else. Okay, maybe a standard for other isekai to strive for, but let's face it, that isn't likely to happen. I'm not going to tell you to go and watch it or anything, as I suspect that you already are. I mean, we are more than 40 episodes in at this point, the controversies and hypes have come and gone, and then come and gone again, and people are capable of making their own decisions. Just as you are capable of commenting and liking and subscribing on this video, and even checking out the sponsor at vittujenkevat. See? I can do a less abrasive transition too. So, finally, a quick word from the channel partners over at vittujenkevat, who are still kind enough to offer me a cut of every purchase made with the link and code. So, if you've ever found yourself in a dire need for a great gift to a life partner, but boring old jewelry won't do, or you just want something funny to get for yourself, head over to vittujenkevat.fi by using the link in the description and browse their immaculate collection of stuff. All of which is naturally themed after genitalia, since dick jokes are the pinnacle of humor. Everything there is handcrafted and very high quality. Don't forget to use the code AddedCheese at checkout for a hefty 10% off your entire purchase. And with that, thank you for watching. I do hope you enjoyed that. If you did, again, YouTube things of likes and comments, subscribes, all of them help hugely. This is still a very, very small channel, and I must one day overcome our great evil overlords at the YouTube algorithm. Anyway, this is also where I would put shoutouts for my channel members and hopefully future Patreon soon enough, if I had any. So if you would like to support the channel, do check out the membership and again, soon the Patreon. I looked into the legalities of it in Finland because our laws are weird. And it seems to be fine, so I'll do a Patreon soon which will contain all of the content you see here on YouTube, except ad-free, mainly because of YouTube's current, let's say, shenanigans with ad-blocking. Anyway, with this, I've been Cheese, and up to next time with more anime goodness, ta-ta for now.